فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على من أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين وعلى آله وصحبه وإخوانه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، somebody asked a question, and inshallah these are two questions in one inshallah ta'ala. The question is what is the ruling regarding reciting beautifully the isti'adha? A'udhu billahi, to recite it beautifully. When you say a'udhu billahi minash shaitani ar-rajim, to recite it beautifully. And the second question is reading the Quran as a congregation, as a group. What is the ruling regarding that as well? And inshallah I will answer both of them together. What we know is that أن التعبد بتحسين الصوت, trying to worship Allah by beautifying your voice, in reciting the Quran, what is known is beautifying your voice and wanting to get closer to Allah through it, is only specifically done for the Quran. The only thing that you can recite beautifully and want to get closer to Allah by that recitation like that is only the Quran. As for anything other than that, it is not allowed for you to do it. Allah says in the Quran, وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا, read the Quran with recitation. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said, وَقُرْآنًا فَرَقْنَاهُ لِتَقْرَأَهُ عَلَى النَّاسِ عَلَى مُكْتٍ وَنَزَّلْنَاهُ تَنْزِيلًا. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, زَيِّنُوا الْقُرْآنَ بِأَصْوَاتِكُمْ, beautify the Quran with your voices. Imam Abu Dawood, he narrated it, Nasa'i, Ibn Majah, Ahmed, on the authority of Bara ibn Azim, and Sheikh Muhammad Nasiruddin al-Albani authenticated it in his Silsila Hadith al-Sahihah. Also the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا أَذِنَ اللَّهُ لِشَيْءٍ مَا أَذِنَ لِلَّبِيٍّ حَسَنِ صَوْتِ يَتَغَنَّى بِالْقُرْآنِ يَجْهَرُ بِهِ. مَا أَذِنَ اللَّهُ, Allah has not permitted لِشَيْءٍ أي matter. مَا أَذِنَ, that which He has permitted لِلَّبِيٍّ أي prophet. حَسَنِ صَوْتِ, beautiful voice. يَتَغَنَّى, who recites the Qur'an with a beautiful voice. يَجْهَرُ بِهِ, he reads it aloud. So what we find out that the Qur'an is the only thing in which you are allowed to recite beautifully and try to get closer to Allah through it. So here the question that arises is that, is the isti'adha, a verse from the Qur'an, is the isti'adha a verse from the Qur'an? But before I go into that, what is important is that the isti'adha was legislated for you to start it before the Qur'an. So you, صِيَانَةً لِلْقِرَاءَةِ, it is a protection for your recitation from what? عَنْ وَسَاوِسِ الشَّيْطَانِ, the whispers of shaitan. Because Allah says in the Qur'an, فَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. If you read the Qur'an, seek refuge in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala from shaitan al-rajim. Ibn Hazm, رحمه الله, he said, قَدْ صَحَّ إجماع جميع قراء أهل الإسلام جيلا بعد جيل. It has unanimously occurred authentically from all the reciters, all of them, generations after generation, على الابتداء بالتعوذ, to start with أعوذ بالله, متصلا بالقراءة, connecting it with your recitation, قبل الأخذ في القراءة, before you try to take a portion from the Quran, meaning before you recite the Quran, that you read it. So that is to show you that it's legislated, but ليست الاستعاذة, the استعاذة is not a verse من القرآن, it is not a verse from the Quran, and everything that is not from the Quran لا يأخذ حكمه, it does not take the law, the legislation or the ruling of the Quran, because أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم is not from the Quran, it doesn't take the ruling of the Quran. سواء من جهة التعبد أو الاستدلال إلا بدليل. It doesn't take it from the angle of worshipping Allah through it, or also using it as evidence, unless an evidence shows that it is. So the أعوذ بالله, you don't read it loudly. ويسر الاستعاذة في الصلاة. So that's what, when you're praying the salah, the استعاذة, you say it low. ولا يجهر بها. A person should not say it loud. Ibn Qudama al-Maqdisi in his great kitab al-Mughni, which is the sharah of the book of al-Imam al-Khiraqi, the Muqtasar al-Khiraqi. Ibn Qudama, that book, he done explanation on that book, Muqtasar al-Khiraqi, Ibn Qudama, which is a kitab fiqh al-Muqaran. He says, لا أعلم فيه خلافا. There is no khilaf amongst the scholars regarding that. That the A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan al-Rajim is read low in the salah, and that you should not read it loud. There's no khilaf amongst the scholars regarding that. That is the first part of the question. The second part, inshallah ta'ala, is what about reciting the Qur'an as a congregation, as a group, as a whole? As for reading the Qur'an together as a group, as a whole, with one voice, wanting to get closer to Allah like this, we say then this is فَهُوَ أَمْرٌ مُحْدَثٌ. It is a newly invented matter. لَمْ يَعْرِفُ السَّلَفُ الصَّالِحُ. The righteous, pious predecessors did not know this matter. But if the person recites the Qur'an as a group, and they listen to each other, and one reads a verse, and the other one reads a verse, and they listen to one another, then there's no problem with that matter. But the problem is, if they're all reading it together with one voice, or part of the verse, as some communities do, at the ending of the verse, they start reading that last part of the verse together. So for example, if the ending of the ayah is وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ, they all say it together. This is also that which is newly invented and has no evidence. Because Allah orders us in the Qur'an that if the Qur'an is recited, we should listen. وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ, if the Qur'an is read, فَاسْتَمِعُوا listen, لَهُ وَأَنْصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Listen and pay attention to it. And to read the Qur'an as a group, and everybody taking a verse, inshallah ta'ala, there's no problem, as it doesn't go against the ayah, and it goes hand in hand, inshallah ta'ala, with the hadith of Imam Abu Sahabi al-Jalil Abu Huraira, as Imam Muslim narrated, Abu Dawood, Ahmad in his Musnad, on the authority of Abu Huraira, that the messenger said, مَجْتَمَعَ قَوْمٌ فِي بَيْتٍ مِّن بُيُوتِ اللَّهِ, that a people do not come together in a house from the houses of Allah, يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ, they read the Qur'an of Allah تبارك وتعالى, وَيَتَدَارَسُونَهُ بَيْنَهُمْ, and they study it with one another, between themselves. Except what happens, إِلَّا نَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ السَّكِينَةِ, tranquility comes down on them, وَغَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةِ, and Allah's mercy will encompass them all, وَحَفَّتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهُ, the angels will go around them, and Allah تبارك وتعالى will mention them amongst His creation. Also, Abi Sa'id al-Khudri narrated عن معاوية رضي الله تعالى, from معاوية, that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم خرج على حلقة من أصحابه, that the Messenger one day came out on a group of his companions, all sitting in a group, circle. فقال, the Prophet said, ما أجلسكم, what sat you guys over here? Why are you all sitting here like this? قالوا جلسنا, we sat together, نذكر الله, we are remembering Allah, ونحمده, and we're praising Him, على ما هدانا للإسلام, that which Allah has guided us on Islam, وما منا ومنا به علينا, and that which Allah has bestowed upon us, which we're remembering that. قال, the Prophet said, الله, by Allah, ما أجلسكم إلا ذاك, nothing made you sit together like this except that. قالوا والله, by Allah, Messenger of Allah, ما أجلسنا إلا ذاك, nothing else made us sit together like this except that matter. Then the Messenger said, أما إني والله, by Allah, I did not, لم أستخلفكم, I did not make you guys say والله تهمة لكم, because I suspected you guys. I didn't make you guys say والله because I suspected you guys. ولكنه, but أتاني جبريل, جبريل came to me, فأخبرني, and he told me, أن الله يباهي بكم الملائكة, that Allah تبارك وتعالى, He mentions you and praises you guys in the presence of His angels. Says, look at my servants over there who are remembering me. والعلم عند الله, وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين, وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وإخوانه إلى يوم الدين, وسلم تسليماً.